Hi friends, in this video, we are going to give you some more information about electric charges. We'll cover the following topics: Coulomb's law, electric field lines and their properties, and modes of charging, by conduction and by induction. Let's begin with Coulomb's law. According to this law, the force exerted between two charges varies inversely as the square of the distance between the charges and is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of the two charges, and it also acts along the line joining the two charges. The expression is given by F, that is force, is equal to K times Q1 multiplied by Q2 divided by R square, where K is a constant. Validity of the Coulomb's law. The Coulomb's law is valid only when the linear size of charged bodies are much smaller than the distance separating them. If the above is true, then only we can ignore the size of the charged bodies and they can be considered as point charges. Let us take an example. Let Q1 is equal to plus 3 coulombs and Q2 is equal to minus 1 coulomb and R is equal to 3 meters. Then, applying Coulomb's law, we get F is equal to K times the magnitude of plus 3 coulomb multiplied by the magnitude of minus 1 coulomb divided by 3 square, which is equal to K times 3 into 1 divided by 3 square. Our next topic is electric field. Electric field due to a charge Q at a point in space may be defined as the force that a unit positive charge, also known as test charge, would experience if placed at that point. The SI unit of electric field is Newton meters. The expression of electric field is E, that is the electric field of Q1 here, is equal to F, that is force, divided by Q2, which is equal to KQ1 divided by R square. The simple basic funda of electric field is, jaise every gunda has his own area, similarly every charge has some area jisme usi ka raj chalta hai. Electric field lines. Some lines or curves are drawn in the area of each charge, such that the tangent drawn to the curve gives the direction of electric field at that point. These lines are known as electric field lines or lines of force. The figure depicts the electric field from an isolated positive charge and an isolated negative charge. Some important general properties of field lines. The first is, field lines always start from a positive charge and end at a negative charge as shown in the figure, but if there is a single charge, it may start or end at infinity. In a charge-free region, electric field lines can be taken to be continuous curves without any breaks. Also, the two field lines can never cross each other. If they did, the field at the point of intersection will not have a unique direction, which is absolutely absurd, as shown in the picture. Electrostatic field lines do not form closed loops like the magnetic field lines due to the conservative nature of electric field. Modes of charging. We are going to discuss two different modes of charging. The first one is charging by conduction. In this method, one charged body is brought in contact with a neutral body and charge flows from the first body to the second body. And hence, the second body is charged by contact, that is, by conduction. The next method is charging by induction. In this method, body is charged without any contact with a charged body. Now let us differentiate between the two, that is, charging by conduction and induction. In conduction, charged object touches the electroscope, whereas in induction, charged object does not touch the electroscope. In conduction, electroscope ends up similarly charged to the object used to charge it, whereas in induction, the electroscope ends up oppositely charged to the object used to charge it. In conduction, the first charge is strong but gets weaker each time the electroscope is recharged. This is due to the original object giving up some charge every time it is touched. Whereas in induction, the first charge is strong and stays strong each time the electroscope is recharged. This is due to the original object not losing any charge in the process. So, today we discussed Coulomb's law, electric field, electric field lines, their properties, modes of charging, that is by conduction and induction. See you soon with our next lesson. Bye-bye.